You want to turn my Frogurt shop into a franchise?
Yes. The company I represent is willing to invest several trillion dollars to convert what was once your humble little shop into a galaxy-wide empire. And the cherry on top? A $5 billion signing bonus. All for you.
$5 billion? That's almost $6 billion.
Go ahead, take her for a spin. Make yourself a cup of Frogurt. We paid careful attention to your signature flavor profiles. You're gonna love it. See for yourself.
Okay, let's see how you did with my chocolate dill pickle. Better collect all the dough in this place. I am Fran of Franz Frogurt's after all. Make it rain! Hey now. Oh, even better than cash. I hate these newfangled...
Ooh, I'm Foopy. It looks like you're trying to pour yogurt. Do you need a foopin' hand?
No.
Foops! Your Frogurt machine requires routine maintenance. Foop on over to the back room. Foop, foop!
Cry out loud! Is everything broken here?
Foop? The only thing broken is you!
What?
What? The maintenance door only foops to foopers with pure hearts. Even the tiniest fooplet knows the secret ingredient to Frogurt is feelings! To enter, you have to confide your deepest, sincere foopy feelings.
I do not use that mode anymore.
Looks like someone is repressing a traumatic memory. Would you like a foop in hand?
No!
That's a foop in shame. You know our policy. If you want a repair, you gotta share.
I can share. You want me to share something personal? Something personal. Something personal. I never got to pork Octavio. That tall stack of man meat.
You're avoiding your true feelings. That foop's my foopin' foop.
Wait, hold on, I can do it.
You can't just foop a suppressed memory from thin air. You have to be relaxed. Gently foop it from your mind.
I'd like to foop you from my mind.
Why don't you do some chores around your store? This place could use fooping up, and the activity is sure to give your memory a foop in the pants.
Go ahead. Explore the space. After all, it's your space.
Foops! You haven't set the foop-approved music, put on the foop-approved uniform, or washed your foopin' hands! Foop privileges denied!
Can't hurt to liven this place up with some tunes.
Please foop a selection.
Pump it up, Promethea. That's not what I fooped. That's not what I fooped! How did you even get this picture? Corporate fat cats keep their loot in places like this.
Salutations. Care for a duel and a thrilling trial of Vaultlanders?
Ah, crap. Okay, Tiny, let's go.
Your jest is hollow. For I am not Tiny. Unless you're referring to my genitals, which I lost in a buzzsaw accident.
Don't care. Let's go.
Select your Vaultlander. Lilith versus Brick Vaultlanders. Fight! Whoa! Ah! Critical! Super Bowl combo! Ho-ho! Woo! Yeah! Land ripping! This is gonna hurt! Ha! You won!
Wow. I'm new to this. Either I'm really good, or you suck.
Both. Wait.
Good boy. Dude in a trunk with no junk. Like what?
You look like poop! Total poop! A thick, steaming pile of poop!
All right! I'll freshen up.
Fooptastic! Please poop your poop.
No, not a chance. This is no time to get existential. Pour that yogurt. Oh, wash my hands, huh? Thanks, Mother. Ew, one of those fancy schmancy Zen fountains. Namaste. I don't know how you're doing this, but something's coming out. All right. I'm ready to share.
Whoopee! I'm all poops.
We were on a trip for field day. A holiday where kids gather to go look at a field. I saw a group of bullies going to town on a poor, defenseless spider ant. And if there's one thing I hate, it's bullies.
What did you do?
What I always did. I got mad. Only this time, I wasn't just mad. This time, I was so angry, I activated my hover chair's mecha mode. In hindsight, it was a smidge of an overreaction. But once I had those bullies in my sight, the rage, it carried me inexorably towards a conclusion I didn't yet know to dread. Caught up in my anger, I launched my... a mecha rocket freeze punch!
Ooh, me! Did they survive?
No, not at all. Neither did that poor spider ant. In fact, it sort of set off what I'd later call my big murder whoopsie. I hit those suckers so hard, they're flying through the air, already dead, and they hit a nearby sitting tank of field gas.
What's field gas?
Gas for the field. The better question is, what was it doing sitting there full that afternoon when the field should have been gassed up already? Anyways, these guys hit the tank, and it's a small explosion. More people died, and they weren't even bullies. I couldn't believe it. And that's when I saw the answer. It was so obvious, right in front of my face, surrounded by other possible options. The aquarium! But instead of putting out the fire like it was supposed to do, it just made things worse.
Water spreads fire when the original source is oil. Fuel gas being oil.
I know that now! The buildings and train station and passing train around the field all went up! More lives lost. I was just trying to help. I would call this my somewhat bigger murder whoopsie. First the bullies, then the field gas explosion. Now I'd been betrayed by water? There was just so much destruction, so much death. I was trapped in a cyclone of emotions, but what I felt most was embarrassed. Anyway, that's how I learned at a young age a painful truth. I am a monster. My inability to control my anger resulted in unimaginable destruction and death. I vowed then and there never to use mecha mode again. But of course, that vow wasn't enough to save me from the worst punishment Promethea can lay on a person. Compulsory anger management.
Oop. Now that's a foopin' feeling! That's the key to friends, family-friendly feeling foopin' Frogert! You've shared. Now... you can repair.
Milking pump malfunction. Milking pump malfunction.
No!
Milking pump malfunction.
What have they done to you?
Restart milk pump or milk provider will be terminated.
I gotta milk you with that machine.
Remember to foop it with a smile. Oops.
So many knickknacks touch everything. The unholy evils that dwell in this Frogurt. Delicious, right? So, are you in or are you out? Take your time, about 10 seconds worth of it. This was a trap. To emotionally devastate you, yes! And it worked! So does my freeze ray. Folia's frozen. If I could find my punch card, the next one should be free!
So, the good guys. Was that all your idea?
I had some help. Just a nerdy sister and an angry woman in a haberdasher.
Co-founders.
Co-founders? That's a strong word. But yeah, they're co-founders. Hey, yo! This song is my jam!
This party's a little dead.
Totally dead.
Why don't you and I head to the VVIP section?
There's a VVIP section?
Here.
The more successful you are, the weirder stuff you're into.
No, Octavio, here in the VVIP section, you find refined recreations for the discerning entrepreneur. Care to stick your face in the belcher? An elite courtesy from the angel investor. Only 11 people in the world have enjoyed mouth gas from the voucher.
I'm not that into drugs, especially from amphibians I don't recognize.
Strange. And all this time I thought you were cool. I mean, you are cool, aren't you, Octavio? I don't know if the angel investor would deign to meet someone who isn't cool.
Damn. Bibbidi Bipster! I'm so cool that I'm above peer pressure. Why? Because I have no peers. My coolness is without equal. That's how cool I am. Astronomically cool!
Oh. Sheesh.
I still wish Anu and Fran were here to see how cool I am.
Everyone is wearing masks. Are you sure they aren't here already?
Good point. Anu, Fran, come try the Belcher. It's for VVIPs. You did it. You actually did it. Full stabilization readings, a perfect fusion reaction. The congripulizer is fully functional. And the best part is, you did it without using the potassium magnesium channels. Absolutely brilliant. You truly have a mind unlike any other. Simply put, you've changed science forever.
Thank you.
Dr. Dar, this is your discovery, your hard work. Would you like to do the honors and activate the congripulizer for its first trial run?
It would be my honor.
She's heading to the observation room.
This kind of looks like a cage.
She's in the observation room.
I believe there's been a mistake. This is actually a cage.
I'm so sorry. We'll get right on that.
You're not doing anything. You put me in a cage.
Amazing! Dr. Dar figured it out.
Okay, I think we're done here. Dr. Dar, thank you for your invaluable contributions.
Are you digging me, huh? You bully! You're all bullies! Stop applauding! It's patronizing!
Woo! This party is hot!
I should take my shirt off.
Or we could go to the VVIP room.
The VVIP room? Yes!
Welcome to the VVVIP Elite Gold Status Lounge.
This isn't a VVVIP Elite Gold Status Lounge. This is a cage!
An exclusive cage.
No! A cage! You tricked me!
Don't think of it as tricked. In the business world, we... Well, we also call it tricked.
Is this because I didn't do the Belcher?
It certainly didn't help your case. But no. No, you were always going to end up here, Octavio.
Let me out! Let me out! Anyone? Please help me! He tricked me! I'm a super successful Dirty 30!
Anu?
Oh, yes. Right there. Put your data right there.
Not really. How did you follow me here?
Inconsequential. I'm here now. It doesn't matter that you and your friends humiliated me in a store. It doesn't matter that I was fired for playing Faultlander. If you have any hope of freeing your little friend, you must first defeat me.
I'd prefer not to.
Luckily, I didn't ask. Now, battle!
God damn it, anyway! Come here!
Select your Faultlander! Mode! Mode! Versus! Mode! Faultlander! Fight! Mommy, I'm scared! Now or toasty! Critical! Hoo-hoo! Hoo! Lander-rific! Critical hit! Ho-ho! Critical! Lander-rific! This is gonna hurt! Ha! Get it! Critical! Toasty! Critical!
Competitor in the galaxy for any years. Eat it, you teeth, you're trash.
You can't have won. I was depending on this. I needed that W.
Between you and me, pal, maybe it's time you got a new hobby. Maybe a new job with an employer that values you. Just food for thought, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe. Thanks. Maybe I'll, catch you later?
I hope not. Wow. Louis! Wake up! I gotta yuck your yum. I apologize in advance.
Why did you do that? I was happy. A smorgasbord of sensations. It was true bliss.
You were happy?
I believe I was, though I have no reference. How would you describe happy?
Happiness is punching sadness in the face.
What happened while I was diverted?
Oh, I relived my suppressed life-defining trauma, and then witnessed my own personal evil in all of its ugliness and terror. Oh, and I also milked a spider ant. To make yogurt.
From your tone, I surmise this is not how yogurt is typically made.
Look, the people here are bad. Very bad. We gotta go find our two dum-dums before they get themselves killed. Come on!
Hey! What's up?
Octavio, you too! We've got to get out of here! We've got to think of something, some way to break out!
This is all part of my plan. In a few moments, I'm springing myself out of here.
How?
I said it's part of the plan. I don't have the other part yet.
Dumb! 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 So dumb!
Okay, I admit I partied a little hard, but that's to be expected. I made Forge's super successful Dirty 30.
Oh my god. Don't you get it? You didn't make that stupid list! It's just one more scam you fell for because reality won't enter your thick skull! That's why you're sitting in a cage! You never think things through, Octavio!
Oh! Gosh, I'm so sorry. I must have mistaken you for someone who also got trapped in a cage!
And there you idiots are! I leave you alone for 10 minutes, and you both get caught by TDR?
Freeze!
You don't have to freeze. You're not a threat.
You two, drop your weapons! Loud and fast-like! I mean, soft and slow-like!
You always mess that up.
Not now. Please, don't undermine me in front of the targets.
Don't listen to them. You can take them.
Shut up!
Shutting up.
My entire body is a weapon.
Then drop it!
As you wish.
Oi! Is that a weapon?
No.
Drop it anyway! Drop them!
Well, that was exactly as easy as I expected it to be. Aw, cute.
Doesn't make a difference. You get over here and I'll put my fist through your...
The company that made your chair? I acquired it ages ago. And I can control it. Any way I please.
And you can make the chair do fart noises.
Hey, you want to talk to the guy in charge? I'm right here.
Here's how it is. Do as I say, or you, and obviously they, die. Now, the device, please.
No.
Hey!
Petulant child. I'll also be taking your Echo Dex.
Never! What's next? You're gonna break Louis?
Why would you even say that?
No need. I think your robot friend will discover he left that little melding of the minds with some dirty data packets.
Now that you mention it, some of the data I just exchanged was unscrupulous. It was all unprotected. They even used my back port. Oh no. Oh no, no, no. I'm riddled with STDs. Software transmitted diseases. I need a moment to run diagnostics and swab my system. Really swab my system.
Louis! This is your plan? Lock us in cages and hurt our feelings and give us diseases and steal our invention and what? Mass produce it? That's not gonna work. We own the patent.
Okay.
You can laugh, but our investor isn't going to be too happy about this. The mystery caller who jumped in to bail us out of sink or swim has our backs. We may not know who they are exactly, but they're somewhere around here. And anyone that could just drop a few billion on us out of the blue, quite obviously, has a lot of resources that should not be crossed. And I'm just now realizing it's you. You're the angel investor.
And there it is.
Well, golly, sure would be nuts if I just bought myself a rich-to-hip translator and funded my own competition. Yuck.
Wait. That box is the angel investor?
Wow. Here's what happens now. Anu, you're coming with me. Kill the others. Kill the himbo last. He means the most to her.
You're not going to kill them.
You don't think so?
Oh, shucks. Y'all trying to cause my bluff?
Damn. Stupid auto-translate.
You, need me to understand the device. And you know, or I know, or we both know, if they die, I won't tell you a thing. So, yeah. Call.
Actually, never mind. No, I've just thought of a much better use for them. You've just earned yourselves front row seats to the hottest show in town. Men, raise the curtain. It's showtime. Thrilled to see so many familiar faces here today. Shut up! Wainwright, Reese, Torg, Karagawa Sr., Athena. Ah, undoubtedly it was your communal sense of self-preservation that motivated you to be here this evening. Well, that and the fact that none of you would let the others get the competitive edge. But now, you ask yourselves, why am I here? And the answer is... a demonstration. Oh, I have gathered you together for a mercifully one-night-only opportunity. To merge with Tedior, or face your swift and utter annihilation. See, since the beginning of civilization, we have pioneered ways to hurt one another. From the stick to the stone, to the stick with a stone tied to the end of it, and onward throughout the ages, to the laser sploder, the rebel yell, and who can forget the iconic face melter. Each one a rung on the ladder toward power, a ladder that we all race to climb. But thanks to the research efforts of Tedior and a few very gracious volunteers. Bring me the buffoon. That one.
Hey, good to see ya! How's it going? Got a new power suit. Hey, Reese. Hey, Honu, it's your old boss. Let's network after this. Synergize, talk through some new inbox. That's investment opportunities.
Octavio!
Gotta tell ya, not getting the best vibe from this being trapped on stage thing.
This woman doesn't know what she's tampering with. We can take her together. I have a company too.
See, something that they know that apparently you don't. A CEO only barters from a position of strength. Now, you may be aware of what the less imaginative among you have been calling green iridium. You've also likely heard by now that my pursuit of it is the entire reason for my invasion of Atlas and this planet. That shard before you is a crystal of such extreme rarity that only a privileged few have ever viewed with their own eyes. Well, at least until Dr. Dar showcased it and its incredible healing properties to the entire planet while begging for money on sink or swim.
Begging? Like, no.
But what Dr. Dar did not know was that the shard that she and her team of imbeciles had acquired was, in fact, the missing half of a true new pair.
A second shard? This seems, and stop me if I'm being pessimistic, but not great.
They're a set? Did we know they came in a set? Are they worth more money in a set?
Oh, so much more. And what the good doctor didn't show you, perhaps because she had no idea, was that the power of these shards can be wielded in more ways than one. Dangerous, yes? Don't worry, in line with her recent groundbreaking research with iridium, work that the world's biggest idiot discarded. Despite how loud that mustache is, Reese, you're on mute. As I was saying, Dr. Dar harnessed this most magnificent healing power with a simple, classic ray gun. Oh, we have her device here. The anti-gun device. Anti-gun, can you imagine? Anyway, quaint, isn't it? Who'd have thought that the idiot CEO of Atlas would overlook and cancel such a quaint little ray gun?
It's made from found materials. It's not quaint. It's eco-friendly. And in my opinion, that makes it really dope.
Point taken. This dope device. This device harnesses, concentrates, and amplifies the shard's effects. Now, thanks to some experiments in our lab earlier, Dr. Dar helped us iterate on the idea a bit. Now, as I begin this demonstration, it is vital that you keep this fact at the front of your minds. TDR is in possession of the only two extant Anahadium shards in existence. Deny my esteemed competition the demonstration that I promised them? I don't think so. As you are about to witness, the race to the top is over. I won! Now you have two choices. You can posture uselessly until I raise your company to the ground and strike your names from the history books, or B, accept defeat, merge your companies with TDR, keep your lives, and call me boss. Go on, call me boss.
Go to hell.
Scathing.
Look at you! No!
Who's the boss?
Suck it, Granny.
No!
killed him. Anyone could have killed him. But he didn't give me what I wanted.
Octavio! Ock!
Welcome back. Now, who's the boss?
Never.
Makes it simple to save a life. But the other makes killing on a massive scale. As easy as breathing. See, with this simple process of rinse and repeat, you can in fact do far more than simply kill. You can obliterate even the most defiant spirit. Now, who's the boss?
You're the boss.
And that is what I'm selling. Now forget about death. Death is so easy, so passe. I am marketing total, absolute submission. God, with these shards, I can take a city, a civilization, an entire planet, and bend it to its knees.
Easy there, Chief. What is this?
The shard! Retrieve the shard!
Criminals. Plunderers. Murderers!
Put her down!
My twin suffers. I suffer. So you will suffer. Your sadism, your greed must be punished.
Holy Froyo.
Our other half.
An experiment. Let's turn Dr. Dar's healing device into a harming device. Put Dr. Dar in the lab, put her idiot brother in a cell as leverage. As for the others, incinerate them.
Do you mean that literally?
Yeah, or is it like a poetic license?
I do not care. That is the point, you incompetent buffoons. They are not worth my consideration. Just kill them.
All great stories must come to an end. And this one, it's filled with blood, bullets, death, heartache, and a smidge of redemption. Like one big old lasagna from hell. It's not looking good for our heroes, who had each been fooled and seduced from their own egos. The dingus fancied himself a celebrity. The nerd believed she was saving the world with all her science. And the rage monster finally dealt with her. What's the clinical phrase? Old crap. Too late, they discovered there's no such thing as a free lunch or a multi-million dollar investment from a mysterious benefactor. Caldwell had them and the whole world in her clutches. The rage monster set for execution. The dingus imprisoned and out of Echodex service. The nerd dissected and discarded. And Promethea, the first target in Tidior's gambit for galactic takeover. What can I say? Fate has no patience for character arcs. And sometimes, the people with the alien-powered super weapons intent on destroying the world win. Not every great story has a happy ending. Now, where were we? Ah, yes, the lasagna.
Happy to see you.
Aww, cute little jabber. This lab's your whole world, isn't it?
I am not a jabber. I'm a scientist with a degree and books.
I think someone needs to be tickled.
Fong, no, I do not need to be
tickly, 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 too. It's a tickle train. Choo choo.
I've evaded your probing tickles.
Hey, don't be scared, little Jabber.
I'm not. Okay. I'm a little scared. Can we just stop and discuss this like adults?
Ah, cute little Jabber thinks she's talking.
I am talking!
24 hours. 24 hours to make this work.
Wait. I remember this. This was the day I needed a miracle. And I don't even believe in miracles.
I leave for a minute and you're fooling around?
Completely useless. Ah, is that really what I said to her?
It's not what you said, but it is how you sounded.
What's the difference?
That's the right question, but not for me to answer. After all, this is your mind laid bare. What, I wonder, are you trying to show yourself?
I want to go back to normal. My reality, right now!
Then take us there. This construct is one of your own making.
What do you mean? I don't have time for this. None of this makes any sense!
Consider, Dr. Dar, that the answers you are seeking lie outside the bounds of what is logical.
We don't have time for this! We need to stop Susan Caldwell. Isn't that why we fused in the first place? To stop her? No! Come back!
What the hell is a Jabber doing in my lab? You know my feelings on animal testing. Release it!
I tried, but this one keeps coming back. I think it loves to work the wheel.
You're free to go, Jabber.
I'm not a Jabber. I'm you. Metaphysically. But if we work together, we can...
You're right. She does want to work the wheel. Let's begin.
Before we do, I thought we could grab dinner in the mess hall first. Take a break. I don't know. Talk about non-work stuff. I'm sort of having a hard time.
Exactly right, Fong. We've wasted enough time. Start it up.
You weren't really listening to her.